take a leg. You need to get inside Buckingham Palace. It's your best hope for weapons and supplies, even if it is overrun by infected. You need to get inside Buckingham Palace. It's your best hope for better weapons and supplies, even if it is overrun by infected. Things could have been so different if people had listened to John Dee. But by the time he saw what was coming, Elizabeth was dead, and James I had no love for prophecies or alchemy. And he was so obsessed with black magic, he wrote a manual called Demonology and sent his witch hunters around England to hang witches and warlocks. Dee had to go into hiding. Bloody idiots.
Thank you.
Shake a leg. You need to get inside Buckingham Palace. It's your best hope for weapons and supplies. Keep my infected. Shake a leg. You need to get inside Buckingham Palace. It's your best hope for weapons and supplies, even if it is overrun by infected.
Just put them home yesterday, didn't I?
Yes.
So what'd you do? Eat them for breakfast?
No.
You really miss the cookies? I like those lemon ones.
Thank you.
They've locked here thinking they'd be safe, that the royals will protect them. But the establishment looks after itself, no one else. God helps those who help themselves. Never forget that. Take a leg. You need to get in. This is where it all started, and this is where it'll end. I promise you. Protect the safe house. Your survival depends on it.
Thank you.
shielded. Watch your back.
Sorry, I should explain. There are security monitors and speakers in the wards. I'm Peter Knight, junior doctor to the royal household. So don't worry, we're not going mad. do you want to find me in that, won't you? Sorry, I know these corridors are labyrinths.
But
that's the point, this is being true about. I suppose I should warn you, there are also a few infected running around in here. Used to be the main group of soldiers, you see. No, they're all infected now. Double shame. But please, don't touch anything. This is all vital scientific work. I'll close the door behind you, just for caution. Sorry, I can't greet you in person. It's safer for both of us. I'm researching a cure for this terrible infection. You see, it's slow going, as I have so few subjects to test on. I know it's more than a group of soldiers. Not my finest hour, I fear. If you'll forgive me for a moment, you can help me. I say, steady on, old girl. Now here's how you could help. There's a book, De Remedis Spiritus. Fascinating text, but what I'm after is Dee's own copy where he made annotations. I believe it's in the palace library, which means going upstairs, I'm afraid. Would you be so kind? Thank you. You're doing ever so well. I do feel awful about the poor guards. But technically, I'm in a mega group myself. Started as an armament and then moved to be here. It's such a shame. Those soldiers were elite. So sad to see them like this.
Chided me thus. Ignorance was the nakedness whereby you first were tormented, and the first plague that fell upon.
Thank you. Thank you.
patient must be restrained, be calmed by any manner of herbal sedative. She seems ravenous, and nothing I feed her can satiate her monstrous appetite. As if compelled by a most foul instinct to devour all life within her reach. She freed herself of her bonds yesterday, and would have gutted our horse alive if I had not reached her in time. I find myself in awe of the piteous state to which man is reduced. A walking conduit, a mere empty coil, which lives only to feed its greedy and carnal instincts.
You must forgive me. I'm not distracted. Ah, yes, Dr. D. John D was a scientist, alchemist, natural philosopher, and all that, to Elizabeth I. Some people say he was even a spy. Imagine that. And D wrote a warning, you see, about this outbreak. Sorry, must dash.
Following the recommendations of De Remedi Secreti, I reduced the pus to a dry powder and discovered that injecting the concoction into the subject, God forgive me that I refer to my own wife as subject, causes the black blood to retract and wither. I glimpsed the flush of my wife's once rosy complexion through the sickness, but alas, she then succumbed to one final fit. And at last, with blessed mercy, ceased moving forever. May God have mercy upon her soul, and allow me now to rest. I remain convinced this volume offers practical methods for obtaining a solution. Perhaps even the key to save us all.
humanity. Even after all vital signs of the subject cease, the body continues to fight the infection. Nathan has thought so. You have to put him out of his misery first. Then take a syringe and fill it up with antibodies. Yeah.